I think it must be potentiometer. What is this? It is a question mark. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. For repairing inverter welding machine, this is our third video. In first video, we checked its primary power supply was fluctuating. The fan was turning on, turning off. We detected two IGBTs short-circuited on this power stage. When we removed that short circuit components, this power supply recovered. In last video, we checked its display was not working. We found this IC was damaged, short circuited, and 5 volt regulator 7805, it was damaged. I replaced that damaged regulator and I replaced this display. I use this meter from other model. In this session, we will perform cold testing for this control card and high power stage. If you don't have good experience in electronics, never try to repair, because here are unisolated live voltage. Take care for the safety. We will not touch any part, any component in this side or in rear side, even the power is applied or removed, until we verify these capacitors are discharged. If there are some voltage, we will discharge these capacitors. If you see the circuit, line voltage are applied at these two points. These AC voltage are reaching to bridge rectifier. It will rectify the voltage. There is no soft starter circuit. There is no current protection. Bridge rectifier will provide voltage to these capacitors, DC voltage. From this DC bank, it will take some voltage. It will drive this low voltage power supply. It will provide 24 volt for fan, and it will provide 15 volt for biasing up this control card and its pulse transformer driver circuit. Then there is 5 volt regulator. It will take 15 volt and it will provide regulated 5 volt for this meter. When we will adjust some current, output current from here, this information will reach to this 3525 IC. It will start to create pulses. These pulses will be amplified by these MOSFETs. These will drive pulse transformer here. Pulse transformer will drive IGBTs, two IGBTs here, one here. That IGBTs will drive this transformer. It will provide output. Here is output rectifier. That rectified voltage will reach out from these two links, this one and this one. Output current in the secondary side, that is being measured by this current shunt resistance. Current flowing in primary side of this transformer is being measured by this current transformer, CT. Now we have two type of current measurement. One in the primary side, second in the secondary side. How much current we adjust from here? What is our requirement? This IC is forced to provide that required current here. It will read back the value of the voltage from this shunt resistance and it will adjust its duty cycle to provide exactly that current which we need. Based on that current, if any time, any short circuit, any abnormal condition, if there is something wrong, this current that is being measured by this CT will exceed from that allowed limit, it will create OC fault, overcurrent fault. When we adjust, let's suppose 100 ampere, its full range is 600. I think it is just right here. I think this machine is unable to provide more than 100 ampere because it is very poor design. Okay, let's suppose I adjust 100 ampere from here. It will start to increase duty cycle until the output arcing current is 100 ampere. When current will try to increase then 100 ampere, it will decrease its switching, its duty cycle, to maintain the current at 100 ampere. In the front panel, there are more two potentiometers. One is ampere, the second is arc force, the third is hot start. I don't know these two potentiometers, what is the role of these potentiometers, because here in this board, it is using 3525 based simple controller card. I don't think that this card has too many features. I disconnected the power. Temperature sensor. If there is high temperature condition, that time it will disconnect the drive in over temperature condition. First we will discharge it. First check voltage, 2.2 volt. These LEDs, red LED okay, green LED okay. Then we have this potentiometer, center pin slider arm. In resistance mode, it's 1K potentiometer, center pin and third pin, in one side it is 0. Slowly rotate clockwise, it's okay. Its resistance must increase gradually. Now we will verify these two potentiometers. These two wires on one potentiometer, the second two wires on the other. It is not responding. Why both potentiometers are not responding? Now in this casing, power cable, power switch, fan, one potentiometer, two LEDs, these are good. I think it must be a potentiometer. It is dead. There is no response. There is no response on any terminal. Thank you. What is theory behind this? I don't know. Do you have any idea about this product? Please write in the comments. Here is 16 and here is website address www.nbhy.com. 16 4. What is the meaning of these digits? I don't know. Here 14 and 3. As its IGBTs were damaged, we need to remove these heat sinks and we need to verify the components connected at the gate. ohms, 20 ohm, 4688 MOSFET set, this one and this one in circuit I demonstrated in my last video. You can check that video, video number displayed on the screen. ohm, 30 ohm in parallel. SG3525. ...390-392 resistor in parallel. ...199 ohms. Now if you want to check input winding of transformer, pulse transformer, we will connect multimeter here. 200 ohms, that is value of this resistor. If I will connect here and I will connect here, I will find 0 ohm resistance. That is actual transformer winding resistance. These two points are going to transformer. But in series of this transformer, this resistor is connected here. And here is LM358. Here is output current feedback network. These two lines, one is common and second line is reaching to this LM358. If the machine is not setting current, at that time we need to replace this IC. Yes, LM358. I will continue in upcoming session. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.